Hi, I'm Ben Andrews and I'm an organic veg farmer from Herefordshire, and I'm stood in one of my kale fields to answer a question I get asked a lot, and that is, how do you control pests in organic farming? Well, unlike conventional farmers, we don't have the same arsenal of chemicals available to us, but there are some natural alternatives. It's a byproduct from olive oil production, a fatty acid. It's great for controlling aphids. Using iron phosphate instead of metaldehyde, it's a fantastic way to control slugs. And a bacteria called Bacillus thuringiensis. It's great for killing caterpillars. Now, all these products are a lot safer to other wildlife than the conventional pesticides. They're a lot more targeted and specific, but you can find yourself using a lot more of them. That can get expensive. So is there an alternative? Well, we found that by boosting biodiversity and encouraging natural predators, we've been able to reduce our reliance on these natural pesticides. Aphids on lettuce used to be a problem for us, and so we'd use a natural pyrethrum, an extract from chrysanthemums, to keep them under control. But not only were we destroying the only food source for ladybirds, it's also causing them some harm as well. One year we decided to just leave the aphids and see what happened. The aphids arrived, but before the pest burden became too much for the lettuce and damage started to be done, ladybird numbers and their larvae increased, took the aphid numbers down to a manageable level, and we haven't had to use anything since, and that's about 5 years ago. This year, to try and tackle the whitefly and cabbage aphid problem on our brassicas, we planted strips of buckwheat and phacelia throughout the crop. This not only attracts beneficial insects, such as hoverflies, whose larvae love feeding on aphids, it also lures the pests off the cash crop and into those margins. Because of the increase in insect life, we're also starting to see an increase in the number of birds that feed on invertebrates, such as skylarks, meadow pipits, and wagtails. These have been in decline in recent years, so it's fantastic to see their numbers on the rise. So by working with nature instead of against it, you can not only boost biodiversity, which is great for the environment, but also save yourself a bit of time and money too. And that is what we call agroecology.